Wow, there's the picture we did yesterday. It's Scarlett Johansson. I'm gonna open EduK2 and let me show you a very simple game I put together last night. Run the game. It's sort of like Frogger, okay? You have to rescue this cat down here. Now, this is intended to be a mobile game, okay? So you have to tap on the screen. Ah! Try it again. Oh no. Again. Okay, I got the cat. Now I have to come back with the cat. Yeah, and you get 1 point if you do that. Now we have another cat. We have to rescue the purple cat. Oh no. I missed. And the cat will move. I have to come back. Okay, let's get the cat. And now we have to come back. Can we do it? No! My score went back to zero. As the score progresses, you can replace the cat for something else, or make the cards go faster, or add more cards. So today I want to show you how to do the screen wrap effect with the cards. So let's go file new. Call this, what can we call this? Let's call this Super Frogger. Super. Now, these green lines are comments. Okay, so you can probably delete a whole lot of those. Let's see. Let's set this to 410 by 720. Place it on the virtual resolution. So it's the same thing. And that is our cell phone size. The frame rate is recommended to leave it at 30 to save battery, okay, on the device. But I like 60, okay. It looks nicer. Okay, so let me go to my folder. So let's load the car and the street. Copy it. Paste this on my media folder. One is called pink and the other one's called street. This is gray, but I don't know why I called it pink. Now, to make this faster, I'm just going to copy and paste these lines here. I'm going to leave this code down in the description below. So before the do, we're going to load the image. Let me change this to pink. And let me run this. That is our image. Let's load our background, okay? Copy load background. Paste it. Try it out. There is our background. Now, this is the X and Y. So the Y, we need to bring down the card a bit lower. So let's say somewhere around 150. Maybe 250. 250 is not too bad there. I like that there. Let's set this at 0. And our card is at 0. Here we're going to extract the position of the pink card. This is going to be the X coordinate of our card. Now we just need to move our card. Okay, so let's get the code. Here's the line we need. And paste it. Well, that's a long line. Okay. Now the sprite position command needs the number of the sprite or the name. You can see the name here. So if this was a sprite 1, this would be like this. And you need an X and Y. Okay, for the position. So this would be X and this would be Y. Let's delete it. I just wanted to show you. So this gets the current position of the sprite plus our bad speed, okay, which could be an actual number. We could set this at 1. Now this needs to be the same as this here, which is 250. Sprite position. Set it to 250. Take out the sprint. We don't actually need that. We got a little error here. Okay. And the reason is because did we call it pink? We didn't call it pink. Okay, we actually call it just sprite. Let's just call it sprite. I forgot to take that off. You can use names instead of the sprite number. So let's run this. And you can see that our car is moving. Wow. So let me print out the sprite current position, which is this here. And that's so we can see where we are on the screen. Run this again. You can see the number here. Now it's at almost 300. So it's about 400. Let me zoom in. So if the pink position, oops, actually we don't need brackets. if that position is greater than 400, then we're going to set the sprite position back to zero. Sprite zero on the X and 250 on the Y. And let's close the if statement. And if, and let's try it out. Let's see if he resets. Hurry up. Whoa, it works. Let's set this at minus, say 100. Run it. We have to wait for the car to get over here. It goes off the screen and it loops. Okay, so let's set the speed of the car randomly. Okay, so let's replace this number by a variable. Let's call this car speed. We have to declare the variable before we can use it. Anywhere before the do, let's call it a car speed equals random. This will be random range from say 1 to 5. So I'm going to take this variable and we're going to reset it every time this happens. Just paste that there and let's run it. So every time the car exits, it's going to start with a new speed or a random speed. Now it's 1. It's 1 to 5. That's a faster one. Slow one. I think you get the point. We can also change the color of the car. So let me just get the code for that. Here's the code for changing the color of the sprite. Again, I will leave this code down in the description below. Yeah, so normally this will look like this. Let me just delete all this for now. Normally the command looks like this. The sprite number. And three zeros, which is RGB. Okay, so the values go to 255 to 255 to 255. So what I'm doing instead of the 255, I'm using a random range from say 50 to 255, and I'm doing that for all of the numbers. Oh, I have a problem here. Let's see. This should be just sprite or the sprite number. Run this. It's gray now. It's green now. Wow. It's purple. It's back to gray again. Pink, like really dark pink. Orange. Purple again. Hey, can we get a yellow one? Come on. We want a yellow one. No, give us a red one, but red is cool too. Okay, let's close this. Okay, so you can see that this is extremely simple, that it's nothing to it. Okay, so I will leave this code down in the description below. You can find all these commands in the help file and the examples from EduK2. Okay, so down below you can see a subscribe button. Subscribe, like the video, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.